वेलकम टू ईपीजी पाठशाला. माय नेम इज़ डॉक्टर पूनम गुलालिया. आई एम फैकल्टी विद द टाटा इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ सोशल साइंसेस. टुडे वी विल बी टेकिंग अप द पेपर ऑन फील्ड वर्क एंड फील्ड सुपरविजन. द मॉड्यूल विच आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग विद यू टुडे इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू फील्ड वर्क. When we speak of field work, which is the core component of the social work profession, we need to keep in mind the objectives with which field work is undertaken. Initially and primarily, field work needs to be understood in terms of what is its concept, what are the learning objectives of field work. We need to also understand the structure and the content of field practicum, which is also known as field work, and to understand the value and need for undertaking field work as a core component of the profession. Lastly, we will discuss the importance of supervision and the need for field contacts as a part of the field work program. Field work is a very integral part of social work education. Field placement opportunities which are provided to you as students are essential for you to engage to become a professional social worker. In the process of undertaking field work, it is important for you to position yourself as a receptive learner in the field work agency or in the field work placement setting. As mentioned earlier, field work is also known as field practicum, field instruction, and sometimes practice learning. It is an essential component of the social work curriculum for consolidating theory and integrating it with practice. Field work provides you an opportunity to integrate the classroom knowledge with the experiential learning from the field. It unifies the profession. It consolidates the program when field work learning is an integral part of theoretical inputs. Social work practice has a common base, and that implies that in the field you need to understand the phases of planned change in the helping process. You will get an exposure to understanding yourself and enable you to enhance your own self-awareness. It also enables you to gather data and assess the social functioning of individuals and families with whom you connect with in terms of clients and beneficiaries in the field. At another level, when working in the community, you will get an opportunity to understand the community context, the attitudes of people in the field, the attitudes of different stakeholders, the political climate, and the scope and necessity for addressing problems and issues which are of concern in the field. There is a course format for fieldwork, by which it implies that whether it is a concurrent fieldwork program or a block fieldwork or a combination of both, the purpose is that it is structured in such a way to stimulate the practices and address the demands of the field. The other purpose of structuring it is for you to be able to see the development sector, to enable you to address the social issues and enhance possibilities of social justice. A code of ethics is followed by all professional social workers when they are in the field. So when we discuss field work and when we want to understand what is the field, we need to see that what are the learning objectives for you as students when you go for field work, which implies that if you are placed in a field work setting or in a field work agency, then you need to understand the mandate of the organization where you are placed for field work, which means that you need to understand the mission of the organization, the vision with which the organization works, the objectives with which the organization carries out its mandates. It implies that you try and understand the organizational structure and get to know what is the agency profile in terms of their delivery. While you are in the field and you are engaging with the agency, through its agency staff, through the field contacts, through the personnel, through the community leaders, through the outreach programs, you will be able to identify the client systems, the beneficiaries of the field, the beneficiaries who connect with the organization, as well as the needs of the client system. Also, it will enable you to see the strengths of the target group, which is also known as the client system, the client group, to enable you to utilize a strengths-based approach for fieldwork. While understanding the agency and in an attempt to understand its structure and functioning, you will also be able to learn of their source of funding, of the way they deliver their objectives, and where it can be strengthened for you to learn from. As mentioned to you, and by now you would have begun to understand that departments of social work in different colleges, schools of social work as they are known in some spaces, all place their students in appropriate fieldwork settings or in agencies or organizations where fieldwork can be undertaken by the student. These organizations, placement settings, social movements, all provide areas of social work interventions to which the students are exposed to and from which the students can learn from. When you as a student are actively involved in the fieldwork placement, you will be able to partake of the functioning of the organization and learn from the staff and the field contacts as they are operationalizing their program. While in the field, you will be asked to and you will be required to develop individual learning plans, which will outline your own learning goals, which will be in consonance with the goals of the organization as well, and in keeping with the goals of the profession. These are outlined in the fieldwork manual of different schools of social work and are provided to students to guide them in the process of fieldwork. Other than the guidance that you receive and the advice that you get from the agency, you will also be provided with individual supervisors who will be allocated to you for you to understand from, learn from, and those who will mentor you while you are in the field. When we speak of organizations and agencies where you will be placed for fieldwork, they will also provide you with their own set of guidelines and rules and regulations which they follow, which you will need to partake of when you are going for fieldwork. The fieldwork program supports students and organizations in working in liaison with each other, in working as a team, in tandem with each other to meet both the goals of fieldwork and the goals outlined by the organization. It is necessary for you to understand that when we speak of organizations, schools of social work, or departments of social work, and the student, these are all different stakeholders in the same space. And there needs to be some kind of mutual agreement between and among these stakeholders when they are in the field. What does it mean to connect with each other and to have some kind of agreement with each other so that the objectives of all are synchronizing with each other to meet the overall goal of the fieldwork program? It implies that you develop, learn to develop and maintain healthy relationships among different stakeholders, including client groups, including target groups. It also implies that the core competencies and the advanced practice competencies, the acquisition of these competencies becomes part of your learning plan, becomes part of your fieldwork goals, and that you take the advice, the mentorship, and the advice provided to you by both the field contacts and the supervisors to enhance these competencies in you for being a professional. It need not be reiterated, but I may still add that mutual agreement implies that there be effective collaboration between the schools of social work, the departments of social work, and its affiliated agencies, which will be many in number when we place a higher number of students across these organizations. When we speak of mutual agreement among different stakeholders, it leads us to the aspect of expectations from the school or the department or the College of Social Work, as it is known in different spaces in the country. The School of Social Work or the Departments of Social Work will need to keep the agency informed of the academic calendar of the school or the department, the curriculum developments which are going on in the particular spaces, and any special events or facilitation workshops which are undertaken for field educators to enable them to enhance their own skills and upgrade their own skills. Also, the school or the Department of Social Work will need to engage with the agency annually or twice a year if it's semester wise in undertaking meetings or in conducting workshops to orient them to the fieldwork program, to inform the field instructors on the various aspects of the curriculum which is taught to students, including the teaching of the core courses which are taught, or the foundation courses which are taught in many schools and departments. It also enables them to advance their practice behaviors, to offer information about new developments in the field which are connected to the academic life of the institute and to the academic life of the student. The other expectations from the agency or the school implies in providing services of developing new areas of practice which are consistent with the school's mission and the goals of the departments of social work. These aspects become essential because the field is a changing context, and as the field changes, as the context changes, and as the social sector changes and emerges and develops, it becomes essential for us to keep the agencies and the organizations involved in partnering with the process. This reinforces our need for partnerships and collaborations and goes in consonance with the schools and the department's mission of enhancing each other's work and role in the field. The expectations in micromanaging students at the agency require that students be made available with physical space and resources so that it is conducive to student learning and professional practice. Taking it from the expectations which are there from the schools and the departments, we also need to understand what does it mean to affiliate with organizations in the field. When the school or the departments send out information or communicate with the agencies about the assigned students prior to the beginning of each academic year, it takes into consonance the needs of the organizations in terms of their mandate and in terms of being able to provide opportunities for student learning. In keeping with this mandate and with the opportunities which are going to be made available to students, it becomes essential that the agency is informed of the academic calendar and special events which we have already covered. The structure of concurrent fieldwork. Fieldwork in the first year of the master's program is concurrent, which means that it runs parallel to the academic program of the schools or the departments of social work. Students are expected to be equally involved in both the academic curriculum, which may be 3 to 4 days of the week, which runs parallel to the fieldwork program, which is 2 days of the week. And students are provided opportunities to work with different population groups, different target groups, based on their interest areas and based on the availability of organizations in the field with which the schools and departments have got ongoing partnerships. What do we mean when we speak of orientation to the field? And what does the field entail? The field is vast, is ever changing, is constantly changing, is challenging, and other than providing learning opportunities, it also enables us to assess ourselves in terms of our understanding of both the field, the context, and self-awareness, which is an essential component of fieldwork. So when we say orientation, it requires students to understand the concepts of fieldwork in social work education. It also implies that by being provided an exposure, you also get sensitized to the core issues, core concerns of the social work profession, to the core concerns of the development sector. Besides, it provides students an opportunity to engage with the urban, rural, tribal contexts, with different fields of practice, with different target groups, with different sectors in terms of age, race, class, caste, gender, ability or disability issues. And last but not the least, it enables students to create awareness about their own selves with respect to the engagement with the field. So when we speak of fieldwork placements, where are the students placed and what does it mean to undertake fieldwork as an integral part of the profession? The broad themes we need to understand around which the fieldwork agencies or the placements are identified by many schools of social work include health, both physical and mental issues, disability issues, education sector, livelihood issues, issues of informal and formal spaces, governance issues, and issues of social exclusion, to name a few. Whichever agency, organization, or placement is selected based on interest areas of the student and availability of the organizations are anchored by the School of Social Work or the Departments of Social Work as a larger forum. The number of students who are placed for fieldwork per agency, per institution setting, or per placement setting, whether government or otherwise, ranges from 2 to 8, but it depends on the reach of the agency, on the profile of the organization, on the mandate of the organization, on where its area of operation is, on what are the facilities available for student learning, on where and what possibilities of anchoring is possible by the agency in terms of agency personnel, trained staff, field contacts, and of course the overall reach of the organization. In many schools of social work, in many departments of social work, a new feature has emerged, which is known as the fieldwork secretariat. This is a team of faculty and supervisors who plan, organize, and facilitate the fieldwork program of the Department of Social Work or the School of Social Work. The fieldwork coordinator is overall in charge and is responsible for coordinating the overall functioning of the fieldwork program. Leading the program, the fieldwork coordinator is facilitated by other members, other faculty members and supervisors of the schools and departments of social work who are overall responsible for the planning of the program, organizing the program, coordinating the activities, and facilitating the agencies, besides mentoring and monitoring the program. The specific responsibilities in this context of the fieldwork secretariat are, as mentioned just now, to plan the program, to facilitate its functioning, to organize the activities, anchor the program center-wise where there are centers in existence, network with the fieldwork agencies, and make a purposeful distribution of students across these fieldwork settings. It also is responsible for troubleshooting, taking care of issues or concerns which may arise in individual organizations due to dynamics in the organizations, due to change in the fieldwork structure, due to turnover of staff in the organization, so that student learning is facilitated. Monitoring the first year fieldwork program or the second year fieldwork program involves a regular review of students' progress and learning through assessments, evaluations, meetings and seminars, most of which are facilitated by faculty of the schools of social work. Having understood the importance of the fieldwork secretariat and the role of the secretariat, we need to come to understand the role and the importance of supervision in the life of the student learner. The primary task of the supervisor in fieldwork is to help maximize the opportunities for the students to learn for themselves, by themselves, but also by shadowing the supervisors and field contacts in the field. Supervisors are also known as mentors or facilitators. Individual mentors or supervisors are provided, allocated to students to guide them in the field, to protect and promote them where required in terms of helping facilitating their learning, in helping them connect with the field contacts, in understanding the agency's structure and functioning, in connecting with the client groups with which the agency works, and in overall enabling them to find a space for themselves in the professional world. Supervisors, whether they are from the departments of social work, whether they are agency-based supervisors, whether they are part-time supervisors, or whether they are full-time supervisors, are preferably and invariably professional social workers who have been in the field for several years and who have undertaken the responsibility for playing a mentoring role, who are qualified by training and expertise, and who are specialized in their own fields of practice by virtue of their own years of experience in the field. In this sense, they are able to play a facilitative role in terms of mentoring students who are raw and new to fieldwork experiences, to fieldwork practices, to the functioning, to the different styles of functioning of organizations, to the different mandates of organizations, whether they are government sector organizations or otherwise. Ideally, it is expected that students are provided with one individual supervisor who will enable them to contact and keep in touch with the agencies where they are anchored, placed for fieldwork. And all students will also connect with field contacts, who are the paraprofessionals in the field, who will be there on a day-to-day basis to guide students during their fieldwork placement. The paraprofessionals in the field, or the field contacts, enable the students to understand the needs of the organization, to understand the mandate of the organization. They also help to oversee the learning tasks of the students, to assist them with any concerns or dilemmas that they may have in the field on a day-to-day basis, and also help evaluate at a primary level the students' own learning, besides providing guidance to them in the fieldwork. Fieldwork, as it is undertaken in the first year of the profession, is very task-oriented, activity-oriented, because it requires students to engage on a day-to-day basis. And sometimes students find it very routine in nature. But it is from this routine work and this task-oriented connections of engaging with the people, engaging with the field, working with people, connecting with target groups, connecting with client groups, with community leaders, on a daily basis, which enables the student to learn. In either case, the paraprofessional or the field contacts who are available for them help them to provide direction and guidance and enable them to connect better with the field. They are largely the link in the human service continuum between the organization and the mandate of the School of Social Work, between the supervisor and the other agency personnel, and help students to move from one step, take one step at a time, and move ahead in the field. Explained to you the mandate of the schools of social work, the availability of mentors in the field and in the school of social work, the possibilities for you to learn from fieldwork experience, it becomes essential to explain what are the expectations from students when they are undertaking fieldwork as a concurrent program, as a regular part of their social work mandate. Largely, as a student, you are expected to put into practice what you have learned from the classroom, whether it's in the core courses, whether it's in the thematic areas, whether it's in the foundation courses, or whether it's any part of the academic curriculum which you are part of. While you are in the field, you are expected to learn about the agency, about the client groups, about yourself, how do you position yourself, where do you need to open up, where do you need to learn by getting aware of your own self, where is it that your strengths lie, where are the hindrances which stop you from connecting with people, from engaging with the agency or with their target groups. These are all expectations which are there from you as a student learner. Other than that, you are expected to engage with people to be able to learn and enhance your practice skills. You should expect to be challenged in the field. So there may be some raw nerves which will unnerve you. You may need to relook at those. When you work as an individual or in a team, what is it that is hindering you or facilitating you as a learner? Moreover, you will be expected to move out of your own comfort zone, be able to connect with people, utilize community resources or resources available in the organization or otherwise to enhance your learning and to contribute to the field. You are expected to be part of the agency since you will be working with the team in the agency. And therefore, you will also need to complete whatever requirements are there for you from the agency as well as from the School of Social Work. So there needs to be a tandem between the objectives of fieldwork, which are stated in the fieldwork manual, which I explained to you during the orientation exercise, which you are part of when you are oriented to the field in the beginning of the year. Wherever there is doubt, you will need to connect again with your mentor or your supervisor or with the field contacts to clarify your doubts and to be able to meet the expectations which are required of you. You will need to work actively to develop your own self-awareness and to remain a positive representative and an active representative of the fieldwork program of the school or the Department of Social Work. To summarize, one can say that fieldwork education is the backbone of the social work profession. It is the pulse of the program, and it does not operate in an educational or a professional vacuum. The context influences the form which fieldwork education takes and the position it is assigned in the profession. Social work educators have, from the earliest days of educating for the profession, recognized the importance of providing learning experiences in fieldwork settings, and over time have increasingly highlighted its importance for enhancing the professional growth. Thank you. And I also hope that you will refer to the e-text on this module, which also has the references, but you would like to read the papers and the articles written by Professor Pathak, Perlman, Biostech. These are over time articles which have influenced the fieldwork program. I also hope that you have learned from this module the importance of fieldwork, and I look forward to further discussions in this regard. Thank you very much.